The folks in Microsoft have released some really cool features for PowerPoint 2016 over the last few months. And by now, you've probably heard of Morph, but now there are glitter pens complete with a ruler for drawing straighter, and icons that you can convert to shapes to recolor and rearrange, and cool new 3D models that you can even rotate and animate. But the question that I get a lot from my students and viewers is, hey, I have PowerPoint 2016, so how come I don't have more for glitter pens or 3D models? And I wish that there was a simple answer to that question, but there isn't. It's complicated. And it's complicated because Microsoft Office 365 subscription models and their Office Insider programs, they're complicated. That said, I will try very hard to make this as simple as possible for you. There are three reasons for why you aren't seeing these features, and it depends on what features you aren't seeing, either Morph, those glitter pens or those 3D models, or some kind of ribbon tab or task pane, one that isn't really publicized much by Microsoft, meaning you try to Google that tab or task pane and not much really comes up about it. So first off, if you are not seeing Morph in the transition area of your ribbon, chances are you have the non-subscription version of PowerPoint 2016, meaning you bought a license for that software and you don't have to pay monthly or annually to renew that license to keep using PowerPoint. You own that software. This is that same software model that has been around the longest that people are most familiar with. But it's also the reason why a lot of people won't have access to all these new features that people are talking about. You only get those new features with that subscription service, with Office 365. And don't be confused by that name, Office 365. It's just the name that they've given their subscription service at Microsoft. So if you have the traditional version of PowerPoint 2016, you'll have to wait, just like you used to wait in the past, for the next version of the software to come out and upgrade then, or purchase an Office 365 subscription if you don't want to wait. Now, if you do see Morph in the transition tab, but don't see other newly advertised features such as 3D models here on the insert tab, then you probably do have the subscription version of PowerPoint, or rather Office 365, but you are not a member of the Office Insider program. At the time of this recording, 3D models is only available if you are an Office Insider. What's that? Well, an Office Insider is a fancy name they give people who are basically public testers for all their new features. Think of the Office Insider program as a sneak peek program where you get to try out the newest Office 365 features before they are widely released to everyone who uses Office 365. Now, in some cases, you might be an insider and you might be on the fast track, but you might see some insider features like 3D models, but not others, like glitter pens. Well, that's because certain insider features are only available on Windows 10. And if you are not seeing some features like glitter pens, for example, you are probably running that version of Office Insider on a different version of Windows. And I'm not even going to attempt to unfold the layers of Office for Mac right now. I'll just include a link below for you explaining that. Now, the last thing you might see in other people's versions of PowerPoint has absolutely nothing to do with Office 365 or the Insider program at all, but with store add-ins or plugins that come with other software, like this ribbon here, the Storyboarding Ribbon. This is actually a really cool special plugin that is installed when you install certain versions of Visual Studio or a separate and free plugin, the Team Foundation Server Office Integration 2017 plugin. People who typically use this tool use it to quickly create website or app mockups or storyboards within PowerPoint. But what's cool about this plugin, even if you're not a developer, is that you can use this pane to create and save your own custom shapes. So, like, I created a clock made out of a bunch of custom shapes that I painstakingly created, and then I just saved it here. Now I can reuse that shape anytime I want, as many times as I want. But that's why you might see that ribbon tab in my videos and not in your own copy of PowerPoint 2016. I actually have Visual Studio on my computer. You probably don't. Well, I really hope that clears up at least some of the confusion surrounding why you might be missing some features in PowerPoint. Have a question? Feel free to leave a comment, or you can submit your questions through the link below.